St Mirren's captain spun the coin. Peacock called correctly, winning choice of ends for Celtic. So the crowd saw Baker kick off for St Mirren. The Saints played in vertical stripes, Celtic in horizontal ones. In the vast setting of Hampden Park, there seemed every promise of a vintage semi-final. Early on, Celtic had a narrow escape when Haffey only half cleared. St Mirren's fire looked too hot for Celtic. Cutting in, outside left Miller took a pass from Rodger and put the ball up to Haffey's head. Goal for the Saints. Celtic's counter-attacks came to nothing, though once or twice they seemed likely to score. The Saints' goal was intact, but back came Celtic, and once again, goalkeeper David Walker kept them out. Alistair Miller was on the Saints' warpath again. Trying to narrow the angle, Frank Haffey came out to meet him, but the ball rolled in. St Mirren 2, Celtic 0. This wasn't at all what the mighty Celtic had expected. They couldn't cope with the tricky swirl of the wind. Fouled here against Celtic. Baker beat Haffey, and it was 3-0 for St Mirren at half-time. Even after the interval, there was no stopping St Mirren. Right half, Jacky Neilson sized up the position, passed to Baker, but this time Haffey saved. Now Celtic attacked, but when it came to the danger point, nobody had the right shooting boots, and without difficulty, Walker cleared his charge. Celtic tried another attack on the left wing. There was a dangerous-looking pass inside, but the shot went over. Back came St Mirren. More danger for Celtic, but no score this time. Almost on time, Bryceland scored goal number 4 for the Saints. What a victory for St Mirren!